Ну вот теперь, наверное, один из самых интересных и сложных вопросов.
Now, probably one of the most interesting and complicated issues. How could such ancient ruins, which are 15 to 10 million years old, reach our time? It turns out that there is nothing strange about this. The possibility of preservation of such ancient ruins is explained by the geological history of the Alpine-Himalayan mountain fault belt and the Andean mountain fault belt. If we take the Alpine-Himalayan mountain fault belt, its development began with the collision of Africa, Arabia and Hindustan with the edge of Europe and Asia. This collision did not happen anywhere at the same time. The main peak of this collision occurred at the turn of the early and middle Miocene about 16 million years ago. Before that time, there was a shallow ocean thesis. Deposition of sediments occurred in the shelf part of the thesis. After the collision, mountains began to rise. In the middle late Miocene 15-11 up to 7 million years ago, this territory was an archipelago of islands of different size. The major islands were the Iberian Peninsula or Spain, Italy, Greece. Turkey too was bounded by seas, but it was a fairly large area. Crimea was a separate small island in the remnants of the Tethys Ocean. Sedimentation occurred there either in coastal area near land in shallow marine conditions or on the islands themselves under continental conditions. These areas of land, these islands were not raised to a great height. For example, in Turkey, in central Anatolia, there were elevated areas with a height of no more than 500 meters. Large lakes, swamps, streams of rivers were on them. In some places, such as Turkey, Italy, there were permanent volcanic eruptions, which led to the accumulation of a large amount of pyroclastic material. All this shows that during the last 15 million years, the territories where we met the ruins of rock, underground and megalithic towns and stone roads and ruts were on land. They constantly uplifted, and from 11 and 5 million years ago even more intensively. Therefore, Neogene ruins, roads and ruts could stay for 15 million years in untouched, unmovement and unburned state.
Возвышенные участки высотой всего до 500 метров, где существовали и озера, и болота, и текли реки, а еще и в некоторых местах, таких как Турция, Италия.
Another thing why they are not destroyed, why they are not washed by erosion, not smoothed by the weathering. Age of rock, underground and megalithic towns and structures is determined, first by their confinement to the Neogene planation plane or surface, and their strong fracturing destruction by faults. In many faults is mineralization. Also their strong weathering, the formation of crust of secondary minerals as a rule, oxides and hydroxides of iron, manganese, calcite and quartz.
Подземных мегалитических городов и дорог и колей, они постоянно воздымались, поэтому они могли остаться в течение 15 миллионов лет назад вполне, как говорится, в нетронутом состоянии.
In some places, for example, in Hurwat Midras in central Israel, we determined very high contents iridium in the crust of the secondary minerals up to 1.5 to 2%. This is anomalous hurricane content, thousands of times greater than at the boundary of the Cretaceous and Paleogene period. The chemical analysis was carried out in the laboratory of Tel Aviv University. That is, it is reliable, several times rejected data. The strongest argument in favor of Neogene age of rock towns and structures is roads. Located on them and, as I said, climbing serpentines and rock towns on surfaces of the plateaus. It is evident that the roots of these roads are left in soft ground, in places practically in liquid mud. Such conditions existed when there were still not petrified sediment or soil. As a rule, these were coastal continental sediments from limestones to red sandstones, gravelites and conglomerates, or tuffs or taffetes. They are mainly of Middle Miocene age. I determined the presence of ruts as benchmark from the middle late Miocene sediments. The fact is that in some regions on the geological maps of Spain, the strata in which ruts are located date back to the Carboniferous, to the Triassic, to the Cretaceous. This gave me great difficulty in determining the age of the ruts. In my opinion, such a dating of strata in the process of geological mapping was done incorrectly. Similar errors occur in geological practice because many strata are similar to one another and do not contain faunal remnants. Therefore, geologists often make mistakes in identifying them. I myself have to face this more than once. Thus, the presence of rats is a benchmark of the Middle Late Miocene sediments. In turn, the Neogene planation plain, the confining of roads, rats and rock underground complex to it, very strong fracturing, destruction by faults and mineralization are all signs that we are dealing with the Neogene complex. Along with strongly altered, strongly weathered rocks covered with crusts of secondary minerals, in some places we met formations, rock complexes and ruts that look rather fresh. There in the Crimea, Spain and other areas. The ruts look as if they had been driven not so long ago. If they had not been petrified, one could say that these are quite recent formations. How could it happen that in some places rock complexes and ruts are strongly weathered, hardly recognizable? In other places, rock complexes and ruts as well as preserved. I associate this with the fact that despite the rise of mountain systems, continental sedimentation was constantly occurring here in lakes, marshes, rivers, coastal marine sediments also deposited. They overlapped rock underground and megalithic complexes and ruts. In the future, with the resumption of the rise of the territories, erosion of these sediments occurred. Ancient rock and megalithic complexes reappeared on the surface. Since in a number of cases they were brought to the surface relatively recently, they didn't yet have time to properly disintegrate due to the action of water and atmosphere. This explains a very curious feature of the history of not only the Alpine-Himalayan mountain fault belt, the Mediterranean, but the whole globe. In the Middle Late Miocene and in a later period, a whole series of catastrophes took place on Earth. Disasters are my specialization. I have been studying them for a long time, for many years. So, in the Middle Late Miocene, between 16 and 5 million years ago, there were several catastrophes. A couple of disasters were in the Pliocene, that is between 5 and 3 million years ago. In the Quaternary period, starting 2.5 million years ago, during the Glacial period, there were even more catastrophic events. At least two such accidents, one on the boundary of the Miocene and Pliocene of the Neogene period, 5.3 million years ago, and the second well studied by us during the Grand Rock, a catastrophe at the turn of the Pleistocene and Holocene of the Quaternary period, 11,700 years ago, were accompanied by the formation of a tsunami wave. What height had the tsunami wave 5.3 million years ago? We do not know. There are only assumptions. The estimated height of the tsunami wave 11,700 years ago was calculated by Vasily Shevchenko at the Computing Center of the Russian Academy of Sciences during the execution of our work on the grant. According to the calculations, the tsunami during the disaster of 11,700 years ago could have a height of 1 to 3 kilometers. It is natural to assume that when such an avalanche of water crashed down on rock and megalithic towns and roads, it carried away all the machinery, all the skeletal remains of people and animals, people themselves, animals and plants. Then all this was stored in intermountain marginal troughs, in rift zones, shelf zones and the continental bottoms. Only rock underground megalithic complexes remained, which the avalanche of water could not carry away because of their massiveness. Water also removed the entire soil layer, and also alluvial, diluvial and other sediments that accumulated during the rise of mountain structures and covered ancient rock underground and megalithic complexes and ruts. There were one disaster. One tsunami wave was not enough for this. Ancient rock underground and megalithic complexes were exposed after a series of catastrophes, after passing several tsunami waves. That is why, and this is my deep conviction, in the Alpine-Himalayan mountain fault belt, the Andean mountain fault belt, in the Mediterranean region, the ancient Neogene formations are so well developed. The fact that there really were floods on Earth is very well seen from the absence of rock piles near the underground cities of Cappadocia. Think about it, the underground city of Derinkuyu has almost 100 meters deep and presumably this can even deeper. The underground city of Kaimakli is not far behind. These two underground cities are connected to each other, Ogzonok is only slightly smaller. The fact that there really were floods on Earth is very well seen from the absence of rock piles near the underground cities of Cappadocia. Think about it, the underground city of Derinkuyu has almost 100 meters deep and presumably this can even deeper. The underground city of Kaimakli is not far behind. These two underground cities are connected to each other, Ogzonok is only slightly smaller. Where did the rock dumps go? They are not in the vicinity. Therefore, except a flood, which carried away somewhere and redistributed the dumps, it is impossible to explain this phenomenon by anything else. But that is not all. On the floor of many underground cities, especially the underground cities of Israel, Maresha, Beth Gavrin, Luzit and others, I observed limit deposits. They completely petrified and formed hills near the walls, up to 1 to 3 meters height. In other places where they were absent here were signs of ripples on the floor, a typical wave surfing activity. All this suggests that if people escape floods in underground cities, then far from always they succeeded. Sooner or later, water penetrated into underground rooms and destroyed everything alive there. There are many other evidences that there was a flood that washed away the sediments that covered ancient rock underground and megalithic complexes. Summarizing all that I was able to investigate during expeditions in the countries of the Mediterranean region, all that other researchers sent me, it is possible to divide the Neogene ruins, the Neogene rock underground megalithic complex, into two parts. Earlier, when I saw that here are such artfully processed rocks, magnificent stone sculptures of animals, birds and people, elements of landscape gardens, I believed that this is a legacy of some ancient harmonious civilization. A civilization that is used to living in harmony with nature, which try not to destroy but to ennoble the natural landscapes. Turn mountains into pyramids, overbuild them with magnificent stone sculptures. All this gave the area a fabulous, fantastic view. However, later when I saw so many roads, I remember a legend of the Yellow Emperor Huangdi in China. He paved many roads on mountain slopes with the help of technical means. When I saw a large number of ruts and prints from the passage of wheeled vehicles and caterpillars, traces of protecting roads and rock structures with the help of mining equipment, I realized that in addition to a harmonious civilization, there was also a technogenic civilization. How they combined with each other? It is difficult to say. However, taking into account that the range between 15 and 7.5 million years ago is huge, 7 10 million years, it is possible to believe that during this time there could exist both harmonious civilizations and technogenic civilizations. Moreover, not one time. Which one of them were earlier, which later, as they alternate in time, it will be possible to restore archaeologists together with geologists if they drop their dogmatic notions that a man occurred 200,000 years ago from a monkey, that no civilization did not exist before. If you look at the fact that they are abundantly represented in the rock, underground and megalithic complexes and start working together, I think it will be possible to restore the history up to 15 million years ago with all the details. Thank you.